Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be discussing how to test an IC695ALG708. This is an RX3I analog output. It's an 8-channel current or voltage. What we're going to talk about is the peripheral devices that you need in order to test this module, how to configure it, how to look for problems. Let's see if it's a failed unit. All right, so the first thing I want to show you guys is the terminal strip is a high density terminal strip. There's 36 terminal screws on this particular one. And when we attach it, the first thing that we want to do is first look at my light pattern here. You should have a green blinking light if it's so far a good working module. Now, I have a red light on my terminal block and nothing in my field status. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this terminal strip on. And I'm going to bring this lever to the upwardmost position. And what happens is it'll draw itself into all the terminal pins, and now we have a solid connection. It detects that the terminal block is there. And our field status is related to these two wires here. So this is an output. It's going to require power coming in from an external source. I have a 24-volt DC power supply. My negative lead is going to the bottom left terminal, which is terminal number 18. And my positive lead is going to terminal 36, bottom right. All right. So when I power that up, I should have a green light. All right. So if for some reason you guys have a module that you don't have a module OK light blinking green, or you know, no light at all, and your field status when you power up your 24-volt power supply is not working, there's likely something immediately wrong with this module and may need replacement or repair. Okay. Another thing that you guys are going to need, I have a Fluke multimeter here. It doesn't have to be Fluke, but you need a multimeter, something that reads in voltage and current so that we can see if these channels are all working. All right. Now the next step is, I'm using Proficy Machine Edition software. I have an open blank file, and the hardware configuration I have so far is exactly what you see here, except for the module that we're testing. Our power supply and CPU are using two slots a piece, so that leaves us with a blank slot on slot number 4. I'm going to right click, or you could double click on slot 4, add module. Analog output, and we want to select the IC695ALG708 and hit OK. Now, this particular unit requires a bit of settings and editing to each channel. First thing that you want to note before you get into the channels is where our reference address is when we want to actually test each channel. Our reference address starts at analog input. Analog output 00001. Okay. So the first thing that we want to do is range type. We're going to do voltage. Voltage or current is what you want to choose. And the first selection is negative 10 to positive 10 volts. So we will want to test the voltage first. Okay, and we're going to do 16-bit integer. All right. So make sure that you guys do that on each one. Voltage. Voltage DC is fine. 16-bit integer. All 8 channels need to be changed over. That way you know that all 8 channels are working. If you're not using all 8 channels, then you may choose to use less, but for the purpose of this test, we're going to test the complete device and make sure it's in good working order. Now that that's done, I'm going to connect up to the processor. Click the handprint, and the handprint toggles us to programmer mode. Stop disabled, which refers to the inputs and outputs are stopped. Configuration and logic are not equal yet. Okay, that's important because the processor was doing something different before we gave it this particular device. So we want to go to target and then to online commands and clear. and we want to clear the bottom two selections, which is controller fault table and IO fault table. And this will keep us from getting hung up when we go through the download, which we're going to do right now. Download and start ActiveTarget. It's very important that you clear those two, because it you will get stopped and it will create a fault or an error if you don't do that. And we're going to download hardware configuration and logic. Okay, well, that's downloading. If you guys want to take a quick look at the wiring diagram, is the same for each channel, meaning that the common probe and the voltage probe are the top and bottom of each selection. So if you look at channel 1, voltage channel 1, it's going to be on the right hand side of the terminal strip. It's 19 for voltage and 21 for common. And similarly, voltage 2 is 1 and 3, meaning it's the top and bottom selection of each channel. The middle selection is used for milliamp. Okay, so we'll get into that when we test the milliamp side of this. So just keep that in mind, and that's the same with all 8 channels. Top and bottom selections are for voltage, and the middle and bottom selection is for milliamp. Okay, now everything's run enabled. That refers to our outputs are now enabled. We can use them. Configuration and logic are equal. So we're going to go down to our default tables. If you don't have this open, you just click and expand the default tables, go to analog output. And we're going to start with channel number 1. All right, that's why that reference address is important. And I'm going to put a value that should yield 10 volts to begin with on each channel. All right. So, if you guys take quick note to my multimeter, what I'm going to do is the probes that relate to the terminal that I was just discussing, for example, on channel 1, this 19 and 21, and we're going to skip 20. If you look on my multimeter, I'm getting 10.5 volts DC. Okay, that's good. So, you know, we get the full 10 volts. And I go to another channel, same exact voltage. It's stable. It's not moving up or down. It's a solid 10.5 volts. Okay. Channel 3. Channel 4, and so on. And you can keep testing these in that manner. However, one thing I'd like you to do if you're going to be testing this and make sure it's in good working order, if you look at the Proficy Machine Edition, I'm going to give that 16,000 as a value, which is half of 32,000, which means it should be half of the voltage. So if I was getting 10 volts, I want to see, or 10.5, I want to see 5 or 5 and a quarter. On this particular voltage. Okay. So in fact, I do have 5.5 volts. And you want to keep, if you want, you can keep going down. You can go down to 8,000 as your value. And you should only have half of what you had before. So if it was 5 volts, you should have 2.5, and so on. And you can do that with each channel. And I think it's important that you do that and you look for stability, because those are the things that can go wrong. If you give it a value of 32,000 and get 10 volts, that's great. If you give it a value of 16,000 and it still reads 10 volts, there's a problem. There's something wrong with that device, and so on. So you want to check that with each channel, and you also want to check that each channel is stable. So your multimeter shouldn't be going erratically up and down values. All right. So we're sure that the voltage DC end of this device works. And the next thing that we want to do is go back into this unit. We're going to stop the outputs. Go to channel 1, and we're only going to change one thing. And that is, we're going to edit the range. Okay, if you look at my arrow here, you see where I've got on the other side of range, it's editable. You can open it up, do 4 to 20 milliamp. Again, I prefer to do all 8 channels, even if you're not using them all. Just make sure it's a completely good working device. And same thing, you're asking it to do something slightly differently. Before we were doing a voltage, so you want to go to online commands, clear. And we want to clear the controller and IO fault tables because we're faulted now. We're asking it to measure milliamp or output milliamp, which is different. So we say okay. And we're going to download that information. Next thing that you want to do while you're waiting for it to download is switch your multimeter over to read milliamps. Okay. And make sure it's milliamps in DC, not AC. Otherwise, you're not going to get a reading. And I don't want you to think that there's something wrong with the device if there really isn't. And once the download is complete, it'll allow us to turn the outputs back on, be back in run mode. I think we're just about there. Apparently, there's a lot of information to download with this particular device. Okay. Now, you want to go about this the same exact way that we went about the voltage, meaning that you want to try different values. It's good to see that it can go to full value, but it's also good to see the value cut in half. And we still have our values here. I'm going to bring channel 1 back up to 32,000. And I'm going to touch my probes. Now, here's where you guys want to keep in mind that we're touching different terminals for these readings now, not the same terminals. Okay, milliamp is measured, channel 1, for example, is measured on 20 is where your positive lead goes, and 21 is where your negative lead goes. Okay? All right, now, this is perfect. My reading is 21, okay? Same thing, you guys want to check for stability. You want to check for full value. All the channels that I have are working perfectly. And you want to go through and test all 8 channels, okay, both sides. Last channel is ending on, channel 8 is ending on terminals 12 and 11. Or 11 positive, 12 negative. Okay, and I want you to do the same thing. Check your channel 1, go to 16,000 for your value, and see if that's made an impact on. Now, I have a reading of 13 when I do that, which is accurate, and I can go down to 8,000, 4,000. You want to just keep seeing it drop, and of course, you know, the bottom most value in 4 to 20 milliamp is going to yield 4 milliamps. So zero should be reading 4 milliamps. It doesn't mean that it's stuck on or if there's anything wrong with it. We've chosen to do 4 to 20 milliamps, not 0 to 20. So keep that in mind also if you see that. So now, just as a quick recap, if you see fluctuating values, that's a problem. You know, erratic readings on your multimeter, that's a problem. If you touch the terminal screws and it just goes to full value, like straight to 21 milliamps or straight to 10 volts, and then when you go to change the value to cut that number in half, that voltage in half, that milliamp in half, it doesn't change, it stays at full value. You've got a failed circuit. More simply, if your field status, which is supposed to detect the 24 volt power supply, if that's not working, you have a problem. And if your module OK light is not on, you've got a problem. And by having a problem, I mean that the device is not going to be working. It needs repair. It needs a replacement. IC695ALG708 is something that we can repair here at PDF Supply. If that's something that you're interested in or need, keep in mind that we have exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and you can see us at pdfsupply.com if that interests you. Thank you.